I don't think I've played a point-and-click adventure with such an inventive fantasy world since Rincewind, and his walking suitcase roamed the streets of Discworld's Ankh-Morpork. German game The Inner World takes place in Asposia, a nation inside the hollow tummy of a rocky planet. Asposia was once powered by sharp breezes that enter through a trio of wind fountains. Now, the wind has stopped, sending Asposia into crisis. This is a fairy tale land of tumble mice, loofs, and deadly gorfs. A place where terrifying multicolored reptiles called basilians turn their residents into stone statues. A place ruled by a cruel wind monk named Conroy. You play as Robert, Conroy's court musician. He's a sweet and innocent boy who has been sheltered from the outside world, leaving him naive and honest to a fault. But Robert is, of course, soon dumped into the real world and forced to fend for himself. And what starts as a simple mission to retrieve a stolen locket turns into a dramatic mission to save the world of Asposia, and a cute coming-of-age story. The writing is funny, imaginative, full of character, and brimming with charm. Some conversations, however, are achingly long. The voice actors are a mixed bag. The main characters, like growling grump Conroy, a plucky rebel named Laura, and the hopelessly optimistic scamp Robert, sound great, but a few of the extras spoil the mood. The Inner World is a very traditional point-and-clicker, so you can expect some truly bizarre and obtuse puzzles. These manic leaps of logic are the sort of conundrums that can only exist in a video game world. But they're well designed. These are complicated multi-step riddles, but it's always made obvious why you should want to go through the incredible faff of pilfering or bartering for an object. And while this is no small game, it's some 6 or 7 hours long, with loads of locations to visit, you are regularly pinned into a handful of screens so you don't have to walk far to find all the necessary bits to solve the puzzle at hand. If you do get stuck, The Inner World contains a hint system, and the developer is careful to only hint at, not spoil, the various head-scratchers at hand. The Inner World is a creative game, with funny writing, and barmy fairy tale characters. And its smart, tightly constructed puzzles will appeal to fans of old-school point-and-click adventures from the 1990s.
I definitely won't be drinking. Hi, Worm. You look thirsty. Come here. The party's over. Hello. Can you help me?
That depends on what you need.
Garbage?
Pardon? Nobody's especially...
Well, I'm actually looking...
Do you need...
Can you help me?
Sorry. If...
But who would...
I own...
What do you sell here?
Well, I... But I...
You sell stick...
Ah, since...
I've... What's that?
This? You sure? At least I...
No thank. Who knows? What's that?
That's... You...
I have no idea. Is empty.
What's the matter?
I can keep the... fun. That won't work. Why should I do that? That's just a random guess, isn't it? Oh, great. My wins. It's too high. I won't get the fish that way. If I tie the end of... I'll have a great net. It's too high. I won't get the pigeon down there like that.